to go here in Corvallis, Oregon. Washington and Oregon State. Oregon State riding the crest of a two-game winning streak in the Pac-10 Conference. Right now they are two up and two down, looking to be plus 500. Let's take a look at the UPS lineups brought to you, as we said, by UPS. First for the Washington Huskies, it'll be Bobby Jones, about whom we spoke, with Mike Jensen and Trey Simmons. And Lo Romar would like to get more offense out of Jensen and Simmons with Brandon Roy and Will Conroy. Lorenzo Romar now in his second year, a 15-25 record at Washington, and just trying to get things headed in the right direction. He feels he's on the cusp, but just not able to get it done. Here's the UPS lineups for the hometown Oregon State Beavers. It'll be David Lucas, who has done the scoring. Kyle Jeffers, a talented freshman, about whom we'll speak. J.S. Nash is playing a little bit hurt today. Chris Stevens, streak shooter, and Lamar Hurd, very capable at the point. Jay John, now an even 21-21 as the head coach at Oregon State in his second year. And we are set to tip it off here. And the crowd, of course, on its feet, and Oregon State controls the tip. Drop it down this time for Lucas. Lucas draws a crowd quickly. Now Nash. Nash nicked a quadricep in the game on Thursday night, says I'm just fine. Stevens takes it hard to the basket, and a good defensive play that time by Simmons.
Yeah, good start by the Huskies. Good defensive effort, and we know this is a team that's explosive. Need to have a little bit better patience, good shot selection, and they need a game from Simmons. Simmons gets no field goals in their loss at Oregon on Thursday.
And Jensen didn't help very much either. Roy and Robinson, who will come off the bench, really took the scoring load on for Washington. They got to get a little bit more even presence on the offensive end. Conroy with a double clutch and draws the foul. He'll go to the free throw line. Let's take a look at the Kyocera game plan. How do you see this one, Dan?
Well, I think a couple of key items. Washington is a club that has to limit turnovers. They just make too many, 15 or less, and they're in pretty good shape. And one thing that the Beavers can do, and how they defeated the Oregon Ducks, they created second opportunities. And if you can get more than one shot when you come down the floor, that will bode well. So I think the big key for the Huskies, if they can just play solid in a half court, Barry, they got a chance to win. You got to keep them out of transition, but they've got to do a good job in their half-court offense.
Missed the first two free throws. That does not bode well. Here's Hurd, a little soft off the window, and the rebound down to Bobby Jones. Here's Conroy. Good penetration. Give it up nicely to Roy to the basket. Ahead, Jeffers beat everybody down, and a foul, and he couldn't finish.
Here's a beautiful fast break and a good move all the way down the middle and a score. And that was execution personified by the Huskies, who were able to get the ball into the middle of the floor and able to finalize. And that's exactly what you want to do.
The freshman, Jeffers. Jeffers, a guy who really plays beyond his years, and in talking to Jay John earlier, he was telling us that one of the reasons is Jeffers comes out of a high school program where he had excellent coaching, Montgomery of Santa Rosa, California.
You know, what a difference it makes if you've got that type of coaching, you can step into this level and be very productive. Jeffers is going to play right behind at the post against Jensen, and Jensen has to make something happen there.
Well, Simmons.
There's a guy that's got to come alive.
Yeah. Simmons for two. And a steal by Simmons all the way to the basket with a finger roll. He's already doubled his output from the other night in Eugene.
And Barry, remember the Huskies, one thing they do well, they steal the ball. This is a club that's super quick, and if they can get some steals and turn them into easy goals, that'll make a big difference.
From the corner, Stevens. He's another one of those guys that can really light it up in a great big hurry. And a steal coming the other way. Quick steal by Oregon State. And here come the Beavers now with an opportunity to tie or take the lead for the first time in this game. Tried to post up Nash that time and went off his hands and out of bounds to Washington. There's a look at Jay John. we said in his second year here at Oregon, has now evened his record at 21-21. He actually feels his team has played better than their 8-6 record this year, that there were a couple of games that they just kind of gave away.
Yeah, he likes this team, obviously a club without a senior on it, and Jay's done a real good job. And Simmons, we knew he had to have a big afternoon getting off with a couple of scores and a terrific steal. So he's alive in this game against Oregon State. Great pass. That was tremendous.
Herb with the pass, Lucas with the finish. Well, the Huskies getting the kind of start that Lorenzo Romar would really want. They haven't missed a shot yet. They're 4-4. There's a rejection by Lucas. Here come the Beavers. 1-on-3, and Stevens did the right thing, giving up on the wing to Nash, who held it up nicely, and now they kick it out. Hurd at the elbow. Unselfish play by the Beavers, but they couldn't convert.
Yeah, now if you're the Huskies, they take a quick shot.
Conroy misses short, and Lucas picks up the loose rebound. There's Lucas shaking everybody on his way.
Lucas, just like he's like a helicopter. You know when you just hover over the goal and just drop it. How many easy scores have the Beavers had so far in the first 4 minutes?
Executing very well.
Yes, they are.
Uh-oh. Look out. 2-on-1 here.
Give it up.
Hurd all the way. Hammered by Johnson to make a case for intentional.
I don't think so. I don't think he maliciously went after Hurd. I thought Bobby Jones tried to reach over for the block. I thought Hurd might give it up to the trailer. I don't think that's intentional.
No, you're right.
Yeah, I think it's a hard foul, but he's not trying to hurt him. Definitely a little bit of contact.
Second foul on Jones, and that is significant. Hurd at the free throw line, and missed that one pretty badly.
Dave Robinson checking Lamar in.
Lamar Hurd, a sophomore, came here from Houston. And a guy who Jerry John feels,
Jim Henson,
if he could just provide a little bit more offensive punch, could be a very effective point guard in this league.
They've got to make that mid-range jumper. And Hurd, not a real good free throw shooter. He's in that 60-61% range. So he's got to work at making some throws. 0-for-2 from the line that time.
Angelo Sakarakis now in the Oregon State lineup. He gives them an outside shooter.
You might say that.
No conscience.
Yeah, Sakarakis is a magnificent shooter, and you don't want to zone when he's in the game.
Nice give that time. Going to the basket. And Roy converts, and a very good pass by Hakeem Rollins.
You know what Rollins did, Barry? You love? He read the defense. Did a great job. Roy just played without the ball.
That was Hanson. Give it up nicely to Potter. Can't convert it, but he'll go to the line.
Huskies foul on number 2, Jake Robinson, his first, Washington's 13 foul.
So Potter will go to the free throw line. 10-8 ball game. The Huskies over the Beavers. They've led it from the outset. Potter at the line. Neither team able to shoot free throws very well so far, but Potter knocks down the first.
Anthony Washington checking in for the Huskies.
Potter gives the Beavers some inside presence at 6'11". Guy plays hard. Pretty good touch around the basket. Washington clears the rebound off the miss. 1-of-2 for Potter. Nate Robinson now in at the point guard spot. Normally a starter, but it's just been a little bit inconsistent, like the rest of his teammates this year. This is Roy trying to create. Pull up. Wouldn't go down. Rebound to Potter. Sakarakis, long-range shooter, and that's putting it lightly. A steal here by Simmons, who's playing very well so far today, keeping his team in it. Robinson open for 3. And after making the first 4, all of a sudden there's a lid on the basket for the Huskies.
Still man-to-man, Barry, by Washington. And I think, obviously, with Sakarakis on the floor, here's a guy right, that's all he does is shoot 3s. He never shoots any 2s.
That's right. But he can make them. Hanson goes home. The basket has it rejected. Potter picks it up.
There's an attention. Potter.
Now, one thing Potter has is soft hands and a good shooting touch. He and Washington have a little bit of a battle down on the block.
And the Beavers lead for the first time in this game, 11-10. Pretty good give that time from Washington to Rollins. Unselfish play by the Huskies.
Hakeem Rollins has been productive. I mean, he's come in the game, made a great pass and a nice shot inside.
Stevens got along the baseline, tried to shuffle it to Potter and a push on Robinson.
They're going to get Robinson. You're right. Good call. You're going to get him with a push. Second foul on Nate Robinson.
In a hurry. He's only been in the game for just a little over a minute. He's picked up two fouls. Jones also has two fouls. 13:55 remaining first half. The Huskies still lead the Beavers. It's a 12-11 ball game here at Gil Coliseum in Corvallis. One-point ball game with 13:55 remaining to be played in the first half. This has really been the way the Huskies have played so far this year. They've been close in almost every game.
Yeah, watch this play. Let's stop it right here for a minute. Here comes Roy's gonna screen and then roll right to the basket and get it. Watch Lamar Hurd. He does not go with his man. He goes and doubles up the ball and watch Roy just go right to the goal all by himself. No vision that time by Hurd. He didn't stay with his guy, but good execution by the Huskies. And again, Hakeem Rollins with a nice pass.
So Lo Romar has made the decision to stay with Nate Robinson despite the two fouls. He's already got Bobby Jones on the bench with two fouls.
Well, and what he's doing right away, because of what you just said, 2-3 zone.
Right.
You don't want to get Nate Robinson that third foul. And now you got to find Sakarakis, number four. It's got, here
he goes.
Here he is. He's out of bounds. Washington bench.
Simmons comes off a screen, can't get it. And Robinson runs the rebound down. And they're going to get a tied up ball call, and the possession arrow is going to be Washington. Watch Sakarakis.
Well, and he wanted the ball. Look where he shoots it. Look at that. He takes a half a step more, and he's out of bounds. But here is a guy, let's see now, he has taken 89 shots on the year and 77 of them have been from three-point range. He's only taken 12 shots inside the arc the whole year. He's my kind of guy.
Well, how he wound up here is interesting too. He showed up actually on a tape when they were looking at Kyle Jeffers, and he was playing against Kyle Jeffers. And Jay Johnson said, who's that guy who's making all those points for the other team? Go down there, take a look at him, he said to one of his coaches. And sure enough, it turned out to be Angelo Sakarakis, a French citizen who was an exchange student in Petaluma, California.
Yeah, he went to Casa Grande High School, and I think in that game, I think he had like 35. And Jay said, hey, you know what? I think we need a shooter. You better look at that guy.
Washington did everything but finish that one for the Huskies. And it's going to be out of bounds to Washington.
Yeah, Jay told his assistants, get down there, and you know what? Any guy that can shoot the ball as well as he can, you know, we can use
him. We'll find a place for him.
We will definitely find a place. And we saw James Davis do that for Oregon on Thursday. I mean, if you could shoot the ball, believe me, there's a spot for you. Might have traveled out of bounds with 5 seconds left.
And a 5 second call against Curtis Allen. And Lo Romar just kind of looking on, saying, that's the kind of thing we've been doing all year.
Yeah, Lorenzo's mystified by this team because it has talent. They're guys that work hard, but they go through spells of each half where they're just not productive, and they can ill afford to do that because they're not strong inside. They don't get many easy scores around the goal unless they steal the ball and get some open court baskets. Look at Sakarakis again, see if they can find him.
Nash, little turnaround. Nash has become a much more of an offensive presence this year. Nate Robinson floats that one up and in. That was not an easy shot.
How about
what
that?
A pass. And Lucas hard to the 10. Terrific pass that time by Nash.
Well, when you got Nash, who is multi-dimensional, he can play one, he can play two, leading the break. And you know one thing about Lucas, he's always there. He's got nice hands, he's available. And the other thing that they do, this Oregon State team, they fast break. When you make a goal, you better be alert because they're going to inbound and come right back down, and they're going to try to get something real quick.
Well, you know, Jay John learned that at the knee of the master.
Yeah, he sure did. And, you know, we were talking about Arizona. And, of course, Jay was an assistant to Lute Olson for many, many years. And Arizona's run into a couple of tough losses, losing to Stanford at home. And then USC, really, Desmond Farmer had 40. You know, Arizona has not lost three conference games in a row in 20 years.
I know it. The Lute Olson
20
era.
20 years, the Lute Olson era. So UCLA's got a chance to defeat Arizona. That game is coming up after ours.
And of course, Jay John has to go down there. His next game after this one is against his old mentor. Defense! 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 This time they pop Robinson. Robinson tried to make his way to the basket. Jeffers got a hand on the ball, knocked it out of bounds. And we're going to get a timeout. With 11:47 remaining to be played here in the first half, and the Oregon State Beavers have now taken the lead by four. It's OSU 18 and Washington 14. We're coming back. Roy in traffic and gets it up and in. Nice effort that time by Roy.
Yeah, Barry, he is a very skilled offensive player. You like Brandon Roy. Had a nice game in Eugene on Thursday. It was 8 out of 10 from the floor. And he's definitely the go-to guy for the Huskies. Again,
Sakarakis that time misses. A quick outlet now to Robinson. I mean, he makes you think about it no matter what. You got to jump out and guard him. Robinson spin, move to the basket, everything but the finish, and a foul.
Well, this is Nate Robinson, and a good play by Lucas to come from behind, but Robinson, very quick and athletic, just could not finish going all the way to the goal, and Anthony Washington picks up the foul. Six team fouls now on the Huskies, and only one on Oregon State. So the Beavers have obviously multiple fouls to take as the remainder of this half goes down. Still 2-3 zone.
And Nash moves over the two-guard spot as Hurd is back in the lineup. And stepping in front nicely was Curtis Allen. Race to the basket, Allen with the finish.
When you make a turnover in the mid-court area against the zone, I mean, it is trouble. And a good effort by Allen to jump in there. You look at the steals. This is not super surprising here because the Huskies, one thing they do, I mean, they're one of the leaders in the Pac-10 in steals.
Stevens comes off screen. He's got a big on him. Should indicate there should be a mismatch someplace. There's Nash for three.
He got that way up in the air. J.S. Nash. He's had a very good first half.
Well, remember, J.S. Nash is a guy, Danny, averaged 32 points a game in high school. So it's not to say he can't play offense, but he didn't look for it last year. This year, it's a different guy. And I think that's significant, too, when you look at what Jay John has done. All his players have improved.
No question. No question. All of his guys have moved up a notch. If you see Anthony Washington, who played limited time but picked up three quick fouls, should be a bonus situation one-on-one for the Beavers.
And it'll be Jeffers who will go to the free throw line. Kyle Jeffers, just a freshman.
You know, Jay John told us that when he recruited Jeffers, Jeffers thought, well, maybe he'd come up, and they were thinking, he's thinking, well, maybe I'll redshirt a year and, you know, get my feet wet. He said, I'm not recruiting you to redshirt a year.
That's right.
I'm recruiting you to play. You got a chance to start.
And he said the attitude that Jeffers has is not like a freshman. He said, I'm going to go out there. He says, I'm going to make a few mistakes. If I make mistakes, I'm not going to make that same mistake a second time. He's not tentative, and he doesn't feel he's going to get the hook if he does make a mistake. He's a very confident freshman, according to his coach.
Oregon State last year, you got to think, they lost Brian Jackson and Phillip Ritchie. They lost two power players inside. So this young guy right here gets an opportunity to step right in and play, Kyle Jeffers, and he's done a good job.
Long three by Allen, knock it down.
Allen has gotten a chance to play the last ball. That's what happens when you lose some games. You're going to shuffle a deck, and he's performed well.
On Robinson in early foul trouble. This is the only senior in this game, Curtis Allen. Was a starter, 2 or 3 year starter. Stevens for three. Can't get that one, and Jensen clears. Looks to get that pass into Rollins, but a good defensive job by Jeffers to deny it.
I think you gotta look for Roy, try to find him.
This is Rollins to the basket, too hard. Again, that's kind of been in microcosm the story of the Huskies, too. They get opportunities, they create opportunities for themselves, they just can't finish the opportunity.
And that's a shot you have to get down. And Akeem Rollins has had a tremendous practice yesterday. All the coaches were talking about how well he did. He made a good, positive move. You just gotta get it to the goal and get it in.
Last week, this was a guy that came up here to Corvallis, and to say that he lit it up is to make an understatement. Yeah. Luke Jackson was unbelievable.
What a game. In a losing effort, Jackson had 39 points and 16 rebounds, and this young guy right here, Lucas, had a big, big second half, had 22 in the second half and dominated the game around the goal. A big win. You see that final for Oregon State. Now, they have not won three conference games in a row in a long, long time. And Jay John's got this club playing well, and the crowd is into it here. They've got a nice crowd, not quite a sellout, but very close. So the fever could be coming back to Corvallis.
And that's the operable words, I think, coming back. I mean, this place at one time, and it wasn't all that many years ago, was happening. I mean, there were good basketball teams in here. Crowd was sold out at all times. And what they've done now is they brought the student section down, which is becoming the norm in the Pac-10 Conference and around the country for that matter. And so it's much more of an active place than it used to be. And if they get a couple of wins, this place is going to be as notorious as Mack Court at Eugene, Oregon. Jensen got a hand on that shot by Hanson.
Yeah, I thought there may have been a block.
Here's a student section we talked about. They call it the Beaver Dam here. The old barnyard cry coming from the student section. They're not quite as creative, I don't think, yet as Oregon, Stanford, or California.
They're getting there, though.
They're getting there.
Yeah, they're getting there. Tough shot. That is a real hard shot. Now, Allen has made a few. Quick shot, well defended.
Meantime, the Huskies are hanging around. It's 21 all.
They're hanging around, and Roy, who's being guarded by a smaller guy, is somebody that has to touch the ball because he's the creative offensive threat for Washington.
There's Allen again, got into traffic, left it that time for Rollins, and this time he does finish. The Huskies have taken the lead again, and for the moment at least, quieted this Gil Coliseum crowd.
Yeah, the 2-3 zone, if you can get some misses on the outside, obviously, you might be able to get your break going. Now, that's a penetration you don't want to happen, and the Huskies dodged a bullet there.
Yeah, they did. On the miss by Stevens, it's going to be out of bounds to Oregon State. When we come back, we'll take a timeout. 7:38 remaining to be played here in the first half. Akeem Rollins didn't finish the first one, but he finished that one, and his team leads it by two. Welcome back, 23-21 ball game, Washington over Oregon State with 7:38 left to be played here in the first half. In the past few months, they have designed and presented this mural up top. This was back in November when they were still creating this mural to honor some of the great players who have played and the great coaches, of course, who have coached here at Oregon State. Remember number 45, Dan? I know you do.
Yeah, A.C. Green and of course, Gary Payton and Brent Berry's up there. And, of course, Slats Gill, Ralph Miller. You know, the murals, they did the same thing at California. And I think it's a great theme to have around the conference because this conference is the conference of champions. And they've had so many tremendous players all through the year. So yeah, I think it adds a nice touch to the arena.
Not to mention the coaches they've had here. Ralph Miller, 674 yards, reversed by Lucas. And Slats Gill, for whom this arena is named, 599 wins. I mean, what is that, 1,273 wins?
That's a few.
That's a lot. Jay John needs 1,100. And,
yeah, he's just 1,100 behind. Yeah. Yeah, Jay looks firmly entrenched here in Corvallis, yeah. And he's got a nice young team, and he's definitely going in the right direction with this club.
I think so too. I think he's only maybe one player away from making a little bit of noise. Off the baseline, that's Rollins, who seems to be taking that good practice he had into this game today. And a steal by Allen, and a foul by Hurd.
State foul,
all of a sudden, this is the way Lorenzo Romar wants his team to play.
And I thought a tremendous pass that time. But look at Jensen drop it down. And Rollins, what happens is he gets behind the defense. As the ball is going to go inside to Jensen, and he's going to find Rollins right underneath the basket and does a very good job of finding him in traffic to drop it down for an easy score. So I thought a nice effort by Rollins and Jensen.
Rollins again, and Lucas got a hand on that. Kick it out for Jensen, and he can't get it. And Nash clears for the Beavers. Stevens open for three. Couldn't get over that time.
Well, I think Jay John, as you see, Stevens with six. Jay John's got his three-point shooting team in the game. So if Washington's got a zone with Sakarakis back there and Stevens, now they're a little bit more of a threat from the perimeter.
Stevens falls down. Allen gets in the lane and really didn't have anything to do with it. Fortunate to have drawn that foul.
Now the question, Barry, is he shooting or was he looking to pass? And you're right, he got in the air here and did a good job of getting through the two defenders. And I thought he was looking pass, not shot. And it should be out of bounds, which it is, to Washington. Only the fourth team foul. Good lob. Oh, great pass.
Sure was.
By Hakeem Wallace.
And then the rejection by Lucas. So three terrific passes and nothing. And nothing.
Watch this lob and look at the directional pass to Jensen. And then right back to the guy who took it out of bounds. And a block. Yeah. So all that and saying, well, let's see if we can get a shot up.
Simmons gets that one up, misses short. And tried to run his own rebound back, couldn't. Nash picks it off the ground. Oh, Nash really hammered. Remember, he bruised a quadricep muscle in the game Thursday night. Goes down hard here again.
Number 42, Mike Jensen, is first. The Huskies 18-5.
So Nash will go to the free throw line. Nash 90% at the line this year, so
that's good.
Yeah, he's 18
right,
to 20.
Yeah, the right guy to get to the line if you're Oregon State. And don't forget, they can do some damage in this last 5-6 minutes. I mean, they're almost in a double bonus.
And you know, they're shooting 75% as a team.
Well, again, he's a lefty.
There you are. There
that's
you
your theory. That's my theory. Too many left-handed guys that can't shoot.
Two for two. Beavs by three. It's been a close game all the way.
Roy has been quiet. Now, he's been defended well. Nash has done a good job on him.
Jensen pulls the trigger and knocks it down.
Jensen not only knocked it down and waved goodbye, but he also waved at the rooting section.
Yes, he did. Inciting the locals.
Yeah, you don't want to get them going. Back in the zone again. You want some penetration and maybe look for a dish on the outside.
They had Stevens wide open for a three, but Nash looked low instead of looking high.
Lamar Hurd, Jim Hansen, check back in the lineup. For James Nash, Kenny Hook.
So Hurd will come in. Hooks leaves and Nash leaves for Oregon State. Hansen also in the ballgame for the Beavers. Tied at 28, just under 5 minutes left, first half. Allen a lane to the basket. Leave it for Rollins. Foul on Jeffries.
Good penetration, and again, Rollins right place at the right. Watch the penetration here by Curtis Allen. I mean, he just blows by the defense and does a nice job to find an open Hakeem Rollins inside.
And Jeffers with no choice really to foul Rollins.
Rollins, Barry, is a biochemistry major. Went to high school in Arizona, was about 6'5", said, look, I really want to play basketball, was offered an academic scholarship to the University of Arizona, went to junior college, Mesa Junior College, and played for Alton Lister, got a couple of inches bigger, developed his game, and now on scholarship here at Oregon State. So here's a guy, very bright young man, biochem guy.
I think Jay John wishes he was at Oregon State.
I mean, He's at Washington. Yeah, thanks, Barry. At Washington, of course. Well, he might try to. No, you can't do that.
No. Hansett has it stolen, then gets it back, and Stevens missed the three short. Rushed that shot a little bit. Good pass that time by Roy to Simmons, and fast hand away beautifully that time by Stevens. Here's Jeffers, Hansett to the basket. Get the ball off the wither with the right hand
and not charge.
Jensen for three.
How about Jensen?
Yep.
Uh-oh. Jensen's got it going. He's an inside guy, but very comfortable facing up.
How about this?
Oh, How about Hansen?
All right. Simmons answers.
This is a game you better not relax. Don't look now, but here come the Beavers.
Hurd's got six assists in this game so far. Very unselfish Oregon State team, and yet they trail by two. Jensen overplayed the pass, almost got it. Jeffers couldn't quite finish that. Conroy with a good look for three. Went down, came out. Stevens for the Beavers.
Got to be in shape to play this game. Jeffers is going, okay, guys, let's just slow down a little bit. Get me in the half court here. Well, they're playing right behind at the post.
And Hansen draws the foul. And they get Roy from behind. Right. I think they're going to say Rollins was guilty of a foul. Oh, it was Roy.
I think some fatigue is setting in, especially with the big guys for the Huskies. Jensen's got some good perimeter shots, but a little bit tired, I thought, on that defensive effort there.
You can see Hansen improving in his free throw shooting after starting out not so good. Pretty nice stroke there. Hansen, another guy who's just contributed to this Beavers team this year. Guy came over from Utah Valley State. He's been on a two-year Mormon mission in Brazil. Older, good maturity level, runs the floor well, good jumper, they say. One out of two.
Well, that was a terrific pass. Now, that didn't result in much, but Trey Simmons gave it to Hakeem Rollins where he could catch it.
Bobby Jones not going to have to be careful. Remember, he's playing with two fouls. Roy at the free throw line couldn't get it. Nash the rebound. Huskies aren't getting many second chances.
That was a long one.
Sakarakis had a good look. And Potter will give him another chance, and Sakarakis will take it.
Sakarakis, you know, he misses one from about 30. He just got it right back and drilled it.
Jones fouled by Nash. That was close to going either way.
It's still may not be a shoot. That's the only the sixth team foul on the Beavers. They've done a great job of staying out of foul trouble and keeping the Huskies off the line.
So 2:22 left in the first half. It's been a seesaw ball game. Oregon State now leads it by two. We're coming back to Gil Coliseum in Corvallis after this. It's the only show in town on a Saturday afternoon here in Corvallis, Oregon, and the home fans enjoyed what they're seeing so far. Been a three-point barrage for Oregon State lately.
Yeah, and led by Angelo Sakarakis and J.S. Nash, two guys that came in, and of course they're playing against the zone here. They've got opportunities, and when you're open, I mean, Oregon State, look at Sakarakis here fading out of bounds. That time he just missed one, got it right back. So the Beavers have done a good job, 5 out of 7 from three. Now, look at from last year, Barry, to this year, increased in terms of points. Look at the Cardinal of Stanford down there, also increased. Of course, Stanford doesn't give up a lot of points.
No, they don't.
Their point differential is pretty good. But good job by both of these clubs just to increase their offensive production.
I think it's also an indication that they have a little bit more talent than they did last year. That's Jones. Good look, but he missed everything. The power of the rebound. Almost too good a look.
Both teams now employing a zone. You saw the last time down, Oregon State was in a zone, and of course, Washington 2-3 zone. So they're trying to find Sakarakis, who's going to run the baseline, and everybody's aware of him. And it might open it up for Hanset inside. Look at Sakarakis.
So what's he doing? Basket.
What is he doing? Well, you're not supposed to go to the basket.
Not a bad idea,
yeah,
though.
Great idea.
Roy, a little two-hopper that won't go, and Potter with another rebound. Nash on the wing. Down low, Hanset reverse, could get it, follow Potter, no follow, again, no. And finally, it's gotten out of there by Simmons. Simmons kick out corner, Conroy wide open, misses.
Those are the ones you've got to get down. Good job by Simmons to draw the defense.
Coming hard, the reverse Nash couldn't find the window. And he knocked it loose from Roy, and Hanset says thank you very much.
Hanset is all over the place. Hanset is unbelievable. How is he just, he just gets it, follows it in, he's scoring, he's rebounding, he's doing everything.
Well, taking a look at what he's doing.
Now, Hanset is a guy that has just a tremendous feel for the game. I mean, he just knows where to be. Here is Sakarakis, and they're saying, is he going to shoot? No, he's not going to take it all the way. And by the way, beautiful move with the left hand to take it to the goal. Look at Sakarakis, Barry. He's, you know, it's kind of an upset here. He's got 3 field goals, but he's only got 2 3-pointers.
That's right.
he just never takes a two-pointer.
Well, he had 6 threes in a game against Willamette. Now, given Willamette may not be the caliber of a Pac-10 opponent, but you make 6 threes, you're doing something right.
Now, Lorenzo Romar coming out of this timeout. The Beavers have put a bit of a run on him. And he's thinking right now, look, guys, we're good. 51 seconds to go in a half. We're down 6. We need something productive here coming out. So let's run a solid play.
Well, Johnson with a good look. He's made 2. Didn't make that one. And it's gotten out of there by Nash. Boy, Nash is tough at both ends, isn't he?
The Huskies have had 3 golden opportunities to drill outside shots, uncontested, and been able to get any of them down. And so now you're giving the Beavers that shot to run it all the way down and get a good shot at the end of that first half.
About 2 seconds difference between the game clock and the shot clock, so both are still on. 10 on the shot clock now, and Hurd will have to work on Allen. They run Sakarakis off the baseline. Now Hurd gets into the lane, leaves it for Nash with a good look. Hit every side of it. Potter couldn't get it. Potter tries again, and that's the horn ending the first half. A lot of second chances for Oregon State down the stretch here. Halftime at Gil Coliseum, and the Oregon State Beavers lead the Washington Huskies 40-34.
the Kyocera halftime show. It's a 40-34 ball game. Oregon State leading the Washington Huskies. Still 20 minutes of basketball remaining to be played. Welcome back. I'm Barry. That guy right there is Dan. And a bit of a well-played ball game so far. I think each team has had its opportunities. I think three-point shooting for Oregon State may be the difference.
Yeah, it may be the difference. But I think if you're Washington, you have to find a way to get to the foul line a little bit more. This is a club that's very good in the open court, but they have to create some opportunities inside. And I thought Oregon State did play a good half. They made their threes. They were very active defensively. I thought their guard play was sensational. And Lucas had a big first half.
Yeah, he did. Especially right out of the blocks. I think David Lucas really was the difference maker. Made two baskets early for Oregon State. Really got him rolling.
Yeah, I thought it really did. And you saw Hurd trying to find Lucas inside. And I thought David got off well. And he hovered right around the goal. Made some easy scores. And, you know, you look at Washington, Barry, and they're a club. And I thought Trey Simmons had to have a good ball game. Didn't get field goal against Oregon. Here he gets a goal, and then he steals the ball, gets an easy score. And that's where I think Washington is in their element. You look at the halftime stats. Look at the free throws. 1 out of 4 for Washington. Not enough. 7 of 13 for Oregon State. Neither team shot it well, but not enough attempts for Washington.
And they made two more threes, did Oregon State. 6 points. That's the difference in the game right now. 40-34 as you look at the Kyocera halftime statistics. We got 20 minutes of basketball left here, and this game is still very much in doubt. We'll come back after this.
Prepare to start the second half. The Beavers will have it to start things. It's a 6-point ball game, 40-34. Quick look at our individual scoring leaders. Simmons with 8, Roy and Jensen with 6 apiece for Washington. Very balanced scoring. Lucas Sakarakis with 8, Nash has 7, Hanson has 7. And also with 6 points is Stevens for Oregon State. So very balanced scoring. Now Hurd has not scored, but he has 6 assists.
Yeah, I think probably the key stat there is Lamar Hurd with 6 assists. So he's done a beautiful job of running the break and directing traffic.
Six assists and just 1 turnover. This is Jeffers low, Hurd high for 3. No. Jensen, nice block out. Rebound and lost the handle. Lucas.
Well, this typifies what has gone wrong with the Huskies. Now here you get a good rebound, you bring the ball down, and all of a sudden active hands knock it away. And that's the kind of rebound you have to be strong, get the break going, and Lorenzo Romar saying, look, we like the effort, just hold on to the ball. We're down 6, and we're going to give this club a chance to put some more distance between us.
Lucas gets the first. Lucas, as we said, has scored 20 points, at least 20, in the last 2 games. And Jay John went over, had to talk to him. He says, okay, now you've had a breakthrough. Now you know what you can do. Are you going to look back, or are you going to look forward? Or are you going to be satisfied? Just kind of let it in the mind of his player. I think the future is all in front of David Lucas.
I think he's looking forward.
Yeah, I do too.
Now they may get Jensen on a rebounding foul. That's 2 quick fouls on Jensen, his 3rd. So the Huskies got some people in foul trouble.
He has 3. Robinson has 3. Jones playing with 2. Huskies will stay in that zone. Lucas draws a crowd, now kicks out for Nash. Nash looking for some help. Now 7 on the shot clock. Stevens got in the air. That's a good call.
Yeah, so the Oregon State fans wanted a bump, but I agree with you. Shot clock winding down. And I thought the defense, I thought he held position. Rollins was just standing there, and he went right over his leg and turned the ball over.
Jensen, guarded by Jeffers, and a kick out for Jones, who has a good look.
Bobby Jones.
First basket of the game for Jones. He got in foul trouble early, took him out of a rhythm.
Now, Jensen brings that element of passing from the low block. I mean, he does a good job of finding guys if he doesn't have the shot himself.
Actually, Jensen had a very nice first half line. 6 points, 2 boards, 2 assists. Jeffers, why not? They leave a lane, he takes it, couldn't convert it. Here come the Huskies. Chance to cut this lead. Conroy, baseline.
All right, good job by Conroy. You certainly like to take that baseline away and force guys to the middle. Get a little bit of help there, but a nice effort by the Huskies. Now they're right back, got a couple of quick goals, only down 4.
And the lob to Jeffers is off his hand and out of bounds to Washington.
All right, Barry, watch how you can set up the shot. The ball's going to go inside right here to Jensen, and he's going to find the open guy after everybody converges. They do a good job of getting it in. Everybody converges. He pitches the ball back out, and you can set up an easy goal by just dropping the ball down and converging on the defense.
Simmons misses that shot. He had a pretty good look, too, and here come the Beavers again. Nash for 3. This is long. Jeffers with good position, and he puts up a brick. Now Nash in traffic, tries to get it out to Lucas, now Hurd. Stevens for 3. Beavers can't find one now. Jeffers again.
How many?
That's 3, and they didn't get it down. Jones underneath, too far underneath. Jumped off. That's the right call also. Jeffers held position nicely, got both hands up. Washington will maintain possession. On the alternating possession arrow.
But what we talked about, second chance points as a key for Oregon State, and they had 3 or 4 efforts here. Good defense by holding position. And you force a jump ball situation and an out of bounds as the possession arrow goes to the Huskies.
Sakarakis will come into the ballgame replacing Stevens for Oregon State. Jay John looking for a hot hand.
Well, especially against the zone.
Yeah.
I mean, you got Sakarakis in there, and certainly, he's a guy that will look for his shot the next time down the floor. Maybe an understatement.
That's right.
Look for a shot.
Conroy for 3. Conroy, another guy like Lucas, a former walk-on, earned a scholarship and has become a very good player.
Great job by Brandon Roy that time, Barry. Just to use his dribble to influence the defense enough to set up that shot. I think you go inside to Lucas. I mean, Jensen does have fouls. He's got the 3 fouls, if you can find him.
Turnaround handset, couldn't get the roll. Lucas, offensive rebound, and
he is a powerhouse inside.
Very quick, like the great rebounders. We always talk about Ike Diago. Quick feet.
Yeah, quick and quick to the ball. May have stepped out of bounds.
Did. Careless turnover. And we're going to take a timeout. 15:48 remaining to be played. It's a 3-point ball game. Oregon State leading the Washington Huskies 44-41. As we move along in the second half here, and it'll be interesting to see what Jay John has to say to his team, whether he tries to draw that foul on the low post Washington players. We're coming back. It's a 3-point ball game, and a game that's really teed up right now for either team, I think, Dan.
Well, it is teed up, and we talked about second chance points. Watch David Lucas. He's going to get right behind the zone. He's going to get in great rebounding position, and nobody is going to screen him out. Look at him. He's going to get all the way inside, and you talk about second chance efforts. Hard to screen a guy out when you're playing zone. You don't have that man-to-man responsibility, but still, you got to be aware of this guy and try to find him.
And you talked about one of the keys to this this game was Oregon State's opportunities in second chance efforts, and David Lucas, of course, creating those. Perfect on the night, 4-4.
All right, look where they start Sakarakis. They bring him right to the middle of the floor and then going to try to run him to the back of the defense, try to get him over here and see if they can find him.
Well, they had him that time, but Nash thought perhaps Sakarakis was going to cut to the basket. Quick whistle on Hanson. And Hanson will sit. Robinson pulls up. Lucas snatching another rebound. Not a great shot.
Tough
by Robinson.
Shot. Yeah, it's a tough shot. We know Nate is good enough where he can make it. Now that's a bomb.
That was
look, at, look at this guy, Lucas. Is it? I mean, he is really putting on a show of how to offensive rebound the ball. Sakarakis with a look at David. I've got great hands, Lucas. Just grab it and finish that big time all the way to the rim. Gets it right up on a sweet spot and a beautiful finish by David Lucas.
Well, talk about a guy playing with confidence.
Yeah, he really is. This guy has come a long, long way from where we saw him as a freshman.
Yeah, started as a walk-off. Yep. In fact, he was just given a scholarship this year.
It's a great story. I mean, for all these guys out there that, you know, are players that don't get scholarships, you look at a guy like David Lucas. I mean, not only is he a big-time player now, but he is someone that's made himself a good player. I mean, he's worked at it.
And I think you could say the same for Will Conroy. Conroy's another guy. He was a walk-on at Washington and, you know, arguably their most effective guard now.
This guy is Sakarakis. He's got unlimited range.
He was
5 feet behind the line. You can't move that line back far enough. Listen to the crowd.
Sakarakis with 11 points in the game. And they're cheering not only here in Corvallis, but I'm sure in Offraville, France, where Sakarakis is from. We're coming back. Oregon State with its biggest lead of the ball game. They lead by 9. It's a 50-41 ball game. Where's Sakarakis shooting from?
Here's Sakarakis. He's going to come all the way out here and set up. Now watch him come all the way out. Now I'll tell you what the Washington defense is thinking. They're going, hey, look, he can't shoot it from there. Look how far he is from the three-point line. He can't shoot it from there, can't? Well, yes, he can. And he has got that kind of range. Barry, this is a good 27-footer by Sakarakis, and it was good all the way. Just a tremendous perimeter player. He adds a new element to the game.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you got to go out and guard him. And, of course, that opens up everything else. That's what Jay John was telling us. You know, he was talking. He said, you know, he's got great range. He's a shooter. He's not always going to make it, you know, but you got to go out and guard him.
Yeah, you got to guard him. And what will happen is if you jump at Sakarakis, it may open it up for Lucas inside. You get that high-low threat. Good effort here coming out of an out-of-bounds for the Huskies. They obviously down 9 now, their biggest deficit of the game. They get Anthony Washington to the foul line.
And Washington somehow got that in. Wasn't pretty, but it went down.
That was all iron.
Yeah.
That was all iron. It was one of those that never hit the backboard.
That's right.
It was the reverse spin iron shot. Went in the back, and it just rolled in. He'll take it.
No luck on the second, though. Potter clears. Beavs have all their shooters in. They have Stevens in the ball game. They have Sakarakis in the ball game. They have Nash in the ball game.
And the Huskies will stay in the zone. So now you've got to extend that zone even further, which may open it up inside. And they're trying to find Sakarakis. They're all talking to themselves, and where is he?
Stevens takes a long three. Can't get it followed. Misses by Hanset, and Rollins finally clears. They're getting a lot of second chances, though. There's Roy and a block foul. Could have gone either way. Call the block on Nash.
Third team foul on the Beavers. I thought Roy also is a kind of guy that's going to have to get proactive now. He's going to have to look for his shot. He's the one guy that can create an opportunity. Well, they're going to say he was in the act of shooting. Jay John saying, you know what, I thought he maybe was not in the act of shooting. Maybe the bump occurred before he was up.
I think Jay John has a pretty good argument here.
Well, it's been a tough afternoon at the line for the Huskies. At the intermission, they were 1 out of 4 from the foul line.
Well, right now, 3 of 8. Sakarakis going end to end here, throws it up and draws a foul.
I think Sakarakis is finding himself. He's a guy that came over for an exchange student, played in at Casa Grande High School in Petaluma. And he's showing you he's got a little quickness going to goal. He's from France. He's a Greek descendant, but from France.
Speaks 4 languages fluently. Speaks English, French, Greek, and Spanish. See his season's average and his average
now,
today.
This is a total upset to me. I figured free throws would be like automatic. Tell Angel, these are only 15-foot shots.
He had not been there before.
Oh, well, that's the reason.
That's one of the reasons.
There they are.
That was his first free throw attempt of the year. Saw that. Ale Sakarakis.
Of course, the Beavers bury back man-to-man. Good defense. Well, that's how you play the post. I mean, that's what you do. You front the post, you're active, and you anticipate.
I'll tell you what, this Beavers team has enough talent to make a little noise. Stevens, good look.
You know what it is with Oregon State? They're playing with a purpose, and they're much more dangerous on the outside this year than they were last year. They couldn't make a shot last year. They had Richie inside, and he was a guy that was the focal point. But they could not make a shot on the outside.
Rollins, he draws a crowd. Post defense pretty good right now for the Beavers. Robinson has to fall away. He gets it down. It was not an easy shot. Stevens thought about it. They left him for a minute. Stevens coming baseline this time. Give it up to Sakarakis.
Why not?
Shot three!
Is putting on a show. Look at him. He's kind of shaking his head. He's getting nervous. He's going, I can't make this many. Well, he did this in France all the time because it's kind of a normal deal for him.
Did enough defensively on Simmons. And here come the Beavers again. Beavers now with an 11-point lead. And
still the zone, Barry. Look for this. Here he is. He's over
Stevens.
Here.
Well, Stevens could shoot it too, though.
You can shoot it, but the way Sakarakis is going, I think you'd like to have him touch the ball.
Allen hard the basket. This is short. Knocked out of bounds. Into the hands of Hurd.
That number 4 here wants the ball. He can't shoot that one, can he?
You can! You can! He can! How about this guy? Angel Sakarakis! He's unbelievable! Talk about no conscience. Well, get him the ball again. What the heck?
What, one more time.
Allen can't quite get it. Ball still loose. Picked up by Allen. He had a look and he turned around. Robinson for 3. No. And Hanset with a rebound.
I think the roof is. He wants it again.
Why not?
The roof will come off the building if he makes another one.
He's already tied his career high with 18 points. There he
Look
is.
At this.
Oh, I missed that one.
All right, take him out.
You got to let him shoot it. And Jay John is talking to him now, saying, and I read his lips, said, that one was too long. Slow down.
The fever is back in Corvallis.
59-45, Oregon State, and Angelo Sakarakis over Washington. We're coming back to Gil Coliseum after this.
Oregon State by 14 with 10:58 remaining to be played in the ball game. It's been the Angelo Sakarakis show.
Here is the Toyota game summary. Sakarakis has equaled his season's high with 18 points, but I can't imagine any more dramatic than the 18 he scored here. Lucas has been a force.
Yeah, Lucas has been really a guy that's been devastating inside. Sakarakis is going to get a bit of a break. They're going to bring the ice out, kind of cool down the arm for a while.
Nash couldn't quite get the roll that time. Couldn't get it over the front rim. And again, Lucas gets on the floor and bodies everywhere. Tied up the ball. Tempers flare, but the officials do a great job. They just jump in, make sure nothing further occurs here. That's what you're supposed to do, though,
yeah,
isn't it?
Absolutely. And when the ball is on the ground, again, I thought a great effort here by Mike Jensen just to really help his team to eliminate an easy score there by Oregon State. The Beavers got on the ground and get the ball out of bounds on the possession arrow.
Stevens, double clutch. Stevens has 10 in the ball game, too. Another guy that I think has improved dramatically
from last year. Stevens is playing with a purpose, too, and he's got a good sense of the game and looking to score.
Again, great hands by Jeffers. Just reached in front. So Hurd will call for a set play here just to kind of settle things down. Well, that's the play. Get it to Lucas. This time, though, Rollins rejects it nicely. He's a shot blocker. Allen coming all the way the other way, has it fast-handed away. Trying to save it off of Nash. I think you're going to get this, Dan, almost.
Bobby Jones checking in for the Huskies. For Mike Jensen.
Barry, watch the inbound play. Here's the ball they're going to bring all the way around to the goal. And watch the quick inbound play. And they're going to drive it all the way to the basket. A good effort there by Stevens to get all alone and lay it up. So that's just a good way to set up your out of bounds against a man-to-man.
16-point lead now, the biggest for the Beavers. And really, this is more about what Oregon State is doing than what Washington isn't. Conroy sticks a three.
And you know, the thing about it is, if you're a Husky fan, there is still time. I mean, there's 10 minutes to go in the game. Only down 13, and this club has put on a big run. I mean, Oregon State has played tremendous. Now back man-to-man are the Huskies, and you go right inside the Lucas. Good defense, though. Good effort.
Yeah, it was. It's two pretty good post-defense series in a row for Washington. Rollins is fouled on his way to the basket.
Oregon State foul, number 35.
Good interior pass that time to Hakeem Rollins, and he does a smart thing. There was definitely leather defensively, but I thought they also got him on the head from the backside. So Jeffers picks up the foul, and Rollins gets to the foul line.
With 8 points in the game.
Angelo Sakarakis checking back in.
Come back. Sakarakis comes back. Chris Stevens leaves and Jeffers leaves for Jay John's Beavers. So the numbers on Sakarakis.
Now if you're the Huskies, Barry, let's press all over the floor. Don't forget, this is one of the leading clubs in the conference in terms of stealing the ball. So they need a few right now. They got to create some turnovers with their pressure man-to-man defense. Get a five count if they can.
Here's where they want the ball, in the hands of Hurd.
Conroy did a good job just to keep him in front that time. No penetration if you're the Huskies.
Nash found the penetration in the lane to the basket, and Allen grabs him on the way. You know, the thing about Curtis Allen, I'll tell you this in a minute. Let's watch this replay.
Well, you like J.S. Nash, and don't forget, he's a lefty here, and you try to really force him back to his right side. Had a good angle that time to take it all the way in to draw the foul.
It's better to say about this guy right here, Curtis Allen, who goes over to talk to Lo Romar. He is the only senior in this game, and interesting thing about him, even though his minutes have diminished, you know, he is the all-time number two free throw shooter in Pac-10 conference history. Shoots at 87%+, only one
career
guy better than that for a career. Yeah, there it is right there.
So you know you'd love to get him to the line, especially late.
So who's the one guy who's
okay,
better? You know it, right?
I know it. Do you know it?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, go ahead.
You go.
No, you go.
Rod Foster. UCLA.
I didn't know it.
Yes. Rod Foster, 88%.
I thought you were going to tell me it was a Stanford player.
No.
Because they seem to get someone to the
floor. They all shoot 80%.
They all do. Now, we thought one of the keys for the Huskies, Barry, in the second half was to get to the foul line much more than they did in the first half. But not only get there, but make your throws. So this is good news for Washington. And we talked about Bobby Jones at the top of the show, and he got those two quick fouls, and I thought he took himself right out of rhythm. And trying to come back now in the last 9 minutes to be productive. If he can get this one down, it gives his team a chance to set their defense, put the press on, and really do what they do best, try to use their quickness to steal the ball.
Yeah, and six unanswered. It's back to a 10-point game. As you said, the clock is no factor whatsoever. Zacharakis gets it across the timeline, now into the hands of the point guard, Hurd.
Now the other factor is five team fouls on one. They still have one to take, and they take it right there. You certainly don't want to foul in the act of shooting. Try to get these guys before they get into the act of shooting.
And it will be a shooting situation. So Allen, a couple of quick fouls.
I think one of the officials, are they going to say it was prior to, so it should be out of bounds.
Originally, they said two shots. Now, they're saying that
that's what Jay Johnson
prior
said.
To.
He's kind of whispering that thought. And
yeah. Zacharakis leaves it this time. With the basket, and Hooks is another guy who Jay John feels, before it's all done, is going to be a real contributor for this Oregon State team.
And that's a real bonus for Hooks. I mean, he's not a guy that is a tremendous perimeter player, but did a good job to get open.
What a block from behind by Hooks. Making it, and then clears it away. Stevens lob, Hurd, no finish. And Washington ball.
No score, but definitely an exciting, proactive play by the Beavers. And that, you know, that's exactly what you'd like to do. Hurd had a good look at it, just couldn't drop it.
Jones tied it. Hooks has come on and made his presence felt. We'll take the timeout. Kenny Hooks from Moss Point, Mississippi, making his presence felt. 64-52, Beavs. Welcome back, Oregon State by 12 with 7:51 left on the Hall of Honor here, or Wall of Honor, I suppose you could say. How about this guy, and do you remember this Bank of America Higher Standards performance? I think we might have been here, Dan. Gary Payton going for 58.
Yeah, 58. I mean, think about it. Look at Gary Payton out of Skyline High School in Oakland, and Certainly, you talk about great, great guards that have ever played in the Pac-10 Conference, and Gary Payton's got to be, he's not at the top. He's right in that top three. I mean, if you look at most points in the game, I remember the Eddie House game.
I know you do.
I was there on that one, and of course, Lou Alcindor, 61.
I think that was, if not his first game, yeah. I think it was his first game.
One of his first.
Stevens picks up the loose ball. Opportunity, Jay.
Again, it typifies the Huskies. They play great defense. They can't pick up the loose ball. Instead of getting the bucket at one end, they give one back at the other. That's like a four-point swing for Washington. But Roy has been quiet offensively, and it's hard, I think, for Washington to win unless Roy puts up some numbers.
Well, has Potter on the foul. Potter says, I have position. I think you might have jumped in, Roy.
I remember Gary Payton having 50 or close to it
a number of times. That's right. Talk about a guy who could take a game over.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Jeffries will come back. Sakalakis leaves, Hooks leaves, and Potter leaves. I thought Hooks was very productive in his few minutes.
Good defense, blocked the shot, very active at the defensive end. The Huskies looking for steal. Double up, take a few chances.
You know, the Beavers have only turned it over three times in the second half, though. They're taking care of the ball pretty well.
Well, they've got guard play. You know, they've got, Stevens can play the point, Hurd can play the point, Nash can handle the ball. I mean, they got three guys that can all handle it. So if you're pressing them, it's very difficult to get steals.
And remember, there's not a senior on this team.
Stevens. Look at Stevens. Back and doesn't miss a beat.
Got beat the other way though. Lucas, tactical foul. Watch the play by Stevens here.
Well, Stevens very adept on the dribble, and you see him go behind the back, and the important thing, he stayed in rhythm and was able to advance the ball and good position to score.
Rattles it out.
Dave Robinson checking in for Brandon Roy for the Huskies.
Very unusual, though, to have a club without a senior.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, there's maybe five or six in the country without a senior on it. Oregon State, one of them. There's only, and we said this before, only 27 seniors in the Pac-10 Conference of the 10 teams. So, obviously, a very young league, some very, very good young guys in this conference.
Nash going to back it out, worked on by Allen.
And now's the time, if you're Oregon State, you'd love to go inside to Lucas and see if he can make something happen going to the basket.
Lucas trying to back down on Rollins, does a good job on him. Now Nash. Jeffers.
Jeffers from JS now.
What a sensational pass by Nash. Very unselfish to find the open guy.
Robinson sticks a three.
Dave Robinson for three.
You really have to like the discipline of this Oregon State team.
Well, and switching gears.
Uh-huh.
Now, you know, they were doing such a beautiful job on the perimeter. Now, you know, coming down the stretch, you'd certainly like to get to the foul line, so they're trying to put the ball inside. Good steal.
Yep, Jones gets to the basket. Nobody going to get him.
Bobby Jones.
Got to keep your poise if you're Oregon State, because Washington's in an all-out press.
And a good
30-second timeout.
Jay John has a word for the official on his way to the timeout huddle.
Well, this is just a great pass inside. We're going to get position and watch the entry pass inside. Let's stop it right here. Stop it right here. Now look at this pass on the outside hand, and then a beautiful turn all the way to the goal by Jeffers. But the pass made it happen by J.S. Nash. He gave it on the outside hand, and that was excellent execution.
Jay John is really hot about something.
I think Jay's upset. He thought there may have been. There's a big guy that's just sitting down right there. Liam Hughes at
at 7'2", they're redshirting him, Barry. He's from England. He's come a long way. He's lost a tremendous amount of body fat. And Jay John said this guy is going to be a force before his career is over here at Oregon State.
He said he's only played 4 years of organized basketball, so very much of a project. But Jay said coming along by leaps and bounds.
Remember Christofferson that played at Oregon. His last year when he played at Oregon, he was a tough guy to guard. I mean, at 7 foot, there's Liam. And he's 7'2 and about 290 now, and he's dropped some weight, and he's working hard, and he's a shot blocker. And he can deflect and alter some shots, practicing every day with this club, and he'll make a big difference in this program when he's eligible next year.
And remember, the point guard, Hurd, a sophomore. Stevens, a sophomore. Nash, a junior. Jeffers, a freshman. And David Lucas, a junior. So that's the starting five.
And Angelo Sakarakis.
Sakarakis,
a freshman.
That's right. Hansett's a junior. Kenny Hooks, who just had a few minutes, but again, Jay John feels before it's done, he will be a real contributor. He's a freshman.
I don't think if you're the Huskies, you have to rely on three. I thought that was good motion. That was really nice. That was well done by Washington.
Nate Robinson, of course, a great football player, starting cornerback at the University of Washington, gave up football this past year because he wanted to concentrate on one sport, and his family wanted him to do so. Basketball was always his favorite, so here he is on the basketball team. A lot of people up in the Pacific Northwest feel that he will again return to the football team at some point before he's all done. Great athlete.
And definitely will be a go-to guy for the Huskies down the stretch here. Made a big three-point goal. They started him right under the basket and brought him out. This is where Washington, they have to get a couple. Well, that's easy there.
Foul from behind.
Got to get some stops. And they lost Hansett under the goal.
Number 15, Bobby Jones.
Well, here is Hurd doing what he does best. He tries to find his teammates. And again, you see Hansett just running around, establishing position, and has the good hands. And quite frankly, Barry, there had to be a defensive lapse there, some confusion, because nobody was on him.
And Hansett can't convert the free throw. Remember, this is still a 10-point game, so time not a huge factor in the game yet.
Especially if the Beavers start missing some free throws.
One out of two. Conroy just blew by everybody that time, left it for Roy, and one. Now look out.
Yeah, this lead is not a safe lead for Oregon State. That's nine in the game. Conroy does a great job to run all the way in, and you see Brandon Roy just being available. Again, you really love to take that baseline. You don't want guys to run the baseline. I mean, you don't have any help on the baseline. They got a free lane. Couldn't convert the three, but still got that deficit to single digits.
9-point ball game now. 4:36 left.
Watch a five count.
Timeout called by Jay John just for that very reason. This is the 32nd timeout. With 4:30 remaining, the Beavers lead it by nine, and I think Jay John was probably worried about a five count.
Well, he's worried about a five count, and he doesn't want his guys to get too conservative. I mean, they can't just run the clock all the way down and expect to score right at the end of the 35.
And that guy, the balding gentleman, he would like me saying that. Mike Riley, one of the really good guys in the college football coaching fraternity, and has done a great job coming over, taking over the coaching reins of this Oregon State Beaver team. He's a local guy, and there's nobody happier than to come back home. He was here earlier, and he really got this program kick-started before Erickson took over, and did wonders with the program, and I think he had a great season, winning his bowl game. Very, not only a good guy, good football coach. Mike Riley. Nash couldn't get it. Lucas is followed, no, and Rollins with an elbow to the face of Hansen. It was accidental. Right?
Yeah, I thought a good no call. Well, that's a tough show. Great pass.
Was
how
it ever?
Great pass by Nate Robinson. I thought he was going to travel on that one. He's found
his teammate running underneath the goal.
7-point
yeah,
ball
don't,
game.
Don't look now, it's seven.
Just inside 4 minutes remaining and a long three by
Stevens is having a tremendous afternoon.
He's got 17 in the ball game and really has let the game come to him. Conroy, again, again, the baseline. And the one.
If you're going to give the baseline, you better get a little bit of help from the weak side of the floor. That's about the third time in a row that a Husky's been able to garner that baseline. And Conroy dished it the first time, but the second time able to find the square up there on the backboard and get it in.
Lucas will leave with his fourth personal foul. So things get a little more serious here for these Oregon State Beavers.
Well, you don't want to sit David Lucas too long. I'm sure Jay John will maybe try to get him in for offense and there's a foul call, get him out of the game when his team's down in defense and try to sub him that way.
So we'll take a timeout with 3:41 remaining to be played in the ball game. And just like that, it is a 7-point ball game. Oregon State leads it 76-69. We're coming back. Coming down the stretch of what is a 7-point ball game now. It was as much as a 16-point Oregon State lead. But you got to give a lot of credit to the Huskies. They're still looking for their first conference win, and they're hanging around, and they're still scratching and clawing.
And they're coming right with their press now, trying to see if they can double up and get active and cause a turnover.
As we said at the beginning of the show, the Huskies have not been blown out a lot. They've been in almost every game they've played this year. Stevens comes up short. Robinson clears. Here come the Huskies.
Oh, this is a big, big possession for the Huskies here.
Conroy, good look for three. Couldn't get it, but there's Roy.
All of a sudden, the building has gotten quiet.
With good reason.
Yeah, good effort by the Huskies to come right back. They had three guys on the offensive glass that time. And I think the Beavers playing a little bit conservative.
Hanset this time penetrates. Now he leaves for Nashville. Back it out.
I think it's a time, too, that I'm sure Jay John will get Lucas back in the game because they need a low post presence in there, even though he does have the four fouls.
And I would expect, likewise, that Washington would take it to him.
Now the shot clock going inside of 10. So the Huskies have done a great job again defensively. They have to just get another stop.
Stevens for three. Couldn't get that one. And Rollins clears one only. And here come the Huskies now down by five with the basketball.
Roy is a trailer. You've got Nate Robinson trying to make something happen. Look at Nate. Wow.
Got in the air. Put it up off the window. No, comes down into the hands of Jones.
But what a comeback by Washington. They had plenty of time. Jay Johnson going to let his club play.
Stevens thought about it. Now he's going to use some clock.
And while the clock does not stop, you still got Lucas and Sakarakis cannot get into the game.
And let's see. Going to get Jones on the foul, and that may be it for him.
Huskies
that's
foul.
His fifth.
Number 15, Bobby Jones, his fifth personal disqualification.
So Jones will have to leave.
I thought a solid game, though, by Bobby Jones. Picked up those two early fouls, went a long way with four, and did a superlative defensive job, as always.
And Jensen will check in.
So Jensen will come into the lineup. Jensen has had a very good game.
David Lucas and Angelo Sakarakis check in for the Beavers. For Chris Stevens and Kyle Jeffers.
So Hanset will go to the free throw line.
And if you're wondering, Hanset's a 52% free throw shooter.
76-73, 147 remaining.
Jim Hansen at the line.
Knocks it in.
Here's our Kyocera play of the game, and whose do you think it is?
Yeah, this is Angelo Sakarakis, one of his multiple three-point efforts, and that one, that still may not have been his longest.
No.
That was a long one, but he had another one on the side that may have been even a little bit longer, but he sure put on a perimeter shooting display this afternoon.
Hansett second, one of two. Conroy with the rebound, four-point lead. Huskies with the ball.
And still plenty of time. Look at this. Driving
all the way.
How about Nate Robinson? What a left hand. Anybody's game now, Barry.
Pretty quick with that first step, too. It's a two-point game. 1:32 left. Well, Jay John was talking today. His team had a 10-point lead at UCLA and let it diminish and lost the game.
Yeah, I think they've got to maybe reverse the ball, look inside, see if they can get something going to the goal.
Hansett, short. Hansett gets it back. Kick it out for Sakarakis. He passes the shot up. Wiser.
Well, we talked about it at the top of the show, second opportunities. And there's a prime example. Huskies got to get that one off the glass.
And overplaying it. Jensen, great effort.
Great defense by Jensen. Beautiful job.
Two-point game. Huskies with the ball and a chance to tie or take the lead. 48 seconds remaining and a timeout called by Lorenzo Romar, and it's going to come down to the last shot. How do you like this?
Well, you know, Barry, you got to give the Huskies all the credit in the world. They were dead in the water and found a way to come back, and they make a great move. Let's just roll it up, roll it forward. They make a great move to come all the way down. I mean, here's the great defense by Jensen. He does a nice job to come all the way out and initiate the fast break and give his team a chance to come all the way down the floor. So Jensen with the defense and the Huskies with an opportunity. Now they call the timeout.
48.4 seconds remaining to be played. Washington on a 9-1 run over the last 3 minutes, but it's the final 48 seconds that will make the difference.
Watch this guy right here, Nate Robinson. See if they can find him, because I think he's the creator for the Huskies. Here he goes.
Baseline. Got around his man. Rejected big time by Hansen.
Not that time.
He is quick, though.
Still plenty of time. Boy, Nash is trying to take away the baseline, but you look at Nate, you talked about his first step. I mean, there are not many guys in college basketball that have that kind of a first step. If Hansett, he went for the big resounding block, but if he could have kept that one in play, that would have been a big, big effort, because his team would have had possession.
Yeah. Now 40 seconds left, 40.7, 22 on a shot clock, although I don't believe that's really a factor. Barry Tompkins, Dan Belwamedy with Bill Coliseum here at Corvallis, Oregon, on the Oregon State campus, where the home team leads it, but what was once a 16-point lead is diminished to two. It's 77 Oregon State, 75 Washington. Washington has the basketball with 22 seconds left on the shot clock and 40 seconds left in the game.
And I thought the difference for Washington is when they got out of the zone, went man-to-man. They really got active defensively, did a good job on the glass. And guys like Nate Robinson and Will Conroy and Brandon Roy have come up big for him. And I thought Jensen's really had a terrific all-around game inside for the Huskies.
So here we go.
I think you look at Robinson or you look at Roy.
Playing Roy tough without the ball. Now he gets it. Now Conroy, kick out Roy, three, won't go. Follow underneath, picked up by Lucas, and a foul.
Roy had a great look. Conroy, penetration, found the open guy, and Roy had a clean look for the lead. And still plenty of time left, because make a quick foul. Here's the move and the pass. Look at the open shot. You've drawn the defense and you're able to kick it back out. And of course, the glass eater, David Lucas, gets up there to corral that rebound.
Eight rebounds in the ballgame for Lucas to go with 15 points, 73% at the free throw line, and perfect today. And rolls it in. Well, this is the important one, though.
Yeah, what an advantage, though, to have that kind of a shooting touch at the line.
Got him both. So now it's two possessions. So now if you're Washington, you got to score quickly, then foul.
Yeah, then foul, and they're gonna. It is a good move, and Jay John's gonna go offense for defense. Don't forget, Lucas has four fouls, and he's a good free throw shooter. So they get him off the floor at this point for the defensive effort, trying to get him back on the foul.
And Robinson trying to break it down and does. Puts it off the window and in.
He is electric going to the goal.
So now 16 ticks left, back to a two-point game. Got a foul quick, maybe go for a steal. You don't get it, you foul. We'll come down the other end now with 15 seconds remaining. Oregon State, incidentally, has already played three overtime games. They've won one of them. In fact, they've played six overtime periods. Here's Robinson.
Yeah, you see Nate Robinson. Again, you're trying not to foul him if you're Oregon State playing good position, but he breaks the defense down as good as anybody in the country with his penetration, does a good job of finishing. And Stevens, another guy that's a tremendous free throw shooter. So it's no accident for Oregon State that the great free throw shooters get the ball at the end of the game. See if they bring everybody off the line.
That is what they're going to do.
Try to set their defense as quick as they can. This is the big one.
And he gets it. So again, two possessions. They'll roll the ball up here. Robinson won't pick it up until it gets near the timeline.
Got to get a quick score. Got to get something. This has to go.
And it doesn't. Off the right side. Long rebound. Loose ball. Robinson runs it down. Here's a three-point try again. He got it. That was Simmons for three.
They don't have one left here.
And they don't have a timeout. So now they're going to inbound the ball. Get a very quick foul. Even then, it's going to be tough. There's the foul with 5.3. So half a second ticked off. Now 5.3 is enough time.
Boy, you got to give the Huskies all the kudos in the world. Here's just a long range jumper to get it down. And then you're wondering why they don't call it. The thing you got to remember, though, the clock stops. So the clock does not continue to run after the ball goes in the last minute. So now they take the ball out of bounds, and no time's expired, and they pick up a foul.
So Stevens with 19 points in the game at the line, looking for number 20. Washington very likely will have at least a shot.
Yeah, no, I think they're going to have a shot. You've got plenty of time with almost 6 seconds to go. And I don't think that Oregon State, it'd be interesting to see if this one goes down, whether they pick up in a backcourt, because if they don't, you're going to allow Washington to roll the ball up the floor and not any time expire. I think maybe you come down, you pick them up token, force them to inbound the ball.
And you know they're going to want to get the ball into the hands of Robinson, who's their quickest player. 5.3 seconds, as you said, that's an eternity.
Yeah,
that's enough time for a three-point shot and a fall.
You bet. And you look at that game reset, the arrow to Washington, both teams in a double bonus. And, of course, the timeout situation. We knew Washington was void of timeouts, but the Beavers still have one to take. And as you said, Barry, all the saves by a ton of overtime games. You're looking right now, one more free throw to go, but Stevens, an 85% free throw shooter. He gets this down. I think the Huskies will have a shot at a three. Now, the other school of thought is if you're sitting over there on that Oregon State bench, do you not allow them to take a three, and while they're bringing the ball up the floor, take a foul? I was a believer in that, not to let them take a three. But at home, they wouldn't be going for a win. They'd be going for a tie, so I don't think you do that if you're Jay Jones. I don't think you make an intentional foul. You're at home, and the worst thing that will happen is over there. Now they let them
roll the ball. So here's Robinson. Pulls up for three. He got it! Tie game, 0.5 left. And that's not going to go even if it's good. How do you like that?
Unbelievable again for Nate Robinson. You don't take the foul. Here's the key point. The ball was allowed to be rolled up the floor without any time expiring. Now watch the ball being rolled up the floor. The clock does not start now till someone touches it. So the clock stays the same. Great job by the, now it starts. Nate Robinson
had a double clutch this too.
Yeah, and he was behind the line. I think the officials can look at a replay to determine. And there may, you know, there was a little bit of contact. I mean, take a look at this. There was a bump a small bump. The official didn't call it, which I thought was wise, but Nate Robinson with a huge three to get this into overtime.
I'll say. Now, as you said, Oregon State will be playing overtime for the fourth time. The officials will look at the monitor, but it definitely, I believe, was a three. I don't think there's any question.
No,
it was a three-point shot.
It looked like we're going to take another good look at it, but check out where. So let's stop it right. All right, there's the line. He's definitely behind the line.
No question.
At least on that replay. I don't think there's any doubt.
So we're going to go overtime again for Oregon State. As we said, this is number four. They played a single overtime, a double overtime, and a triple overtime. They've won one of them. Five-minute overtime coming up when we come back. Nate Robinson's heroics have forced the extension of this game. Tied at 83 at the end of regulation, we'll play a five-minute overtime. And it's one of those games, Dan, that is wide open to wouldas and couldas and shouldas.
Yeah, it's so many things when you look back on this game for Oregon State that they could have done. But the fact of the matter is that Washington and Nate Robinson just would not let his team lose. And Oregon State's played a great game, but I thought Washington, when they went to the man-to-man late in that second half, really turned the game around with their defense.
So, Jay John, obviously, I'm sure questioning some of the decision-making that he made, but you make it and you live with it. Oregon State will have the first possession. And a steal by Robinson.
Robinson is all over the place. He has been unbelievable in terms of his defense, his explosiveness, his ability to make big shots, and Nate Robinson putting on quite a show here at in Corvallis.
Yeah, down the stretch especially. And there's another steal.
Again, been the Nate Robinson show.
Well, you know, it's interesting. The crowd, both here and at Oregon, was really on Nate Robinson. Calling him Gary Coleman, holding up pictures. And we were talking to the Washington coaches at breakfast this morning. They were talking about the fact that, asking us, was he responding? And we said, no, he was very cool about it. And they said, that means he's pissed.
Well, I thought Nate handled it very well. And there again, Hakeem Rollins, now the recipient of that beautiful pass inside. And they've shaken Oregon State. No question. This is not the same team that we saw at the start of the second half.
So the Huskies with the first two baskets of the overtime period, lead it by four. A miss, a rebound by Conroy.
Now I think if you're Washington, let's go with what was effective. Trying to take a look at Robinson coming off screens, Brandon Roy. Hakeem Rollins inside has been very effective.
I want to remind those of you who are with us on this game that as soon as it is over, as Roy knocks one down, we'll take you either to the UCLA-Arizona women's game or into the Big 12 Baylor at Texas Tech.
A quick timeout. Well, the Huskies picking up right where they left off. Three goals in a row for Washington.
Now at just under the three-minute mark remaining to be played. The tie at the end of regulation at 83 was the first tie since the four-minute mark in the first half.
Look at this run. I mean, this is incredible. Look at over the last 7 minutes, 30-12. Now, you've got to have some talent to put on that kind of a run late in the game.
Well, they're very athletic, and we said that earlier. What they have not been able to do is close the deal. Well, maybe they're on the cusp of closing the deal here, and then who knows what might happen with the Huskies. They, too, have been, as we said, in very close games. They almost handled UCLA.
Yeah, they lose in overtime in that game.
Oregon State still scoreless in the overtime period and have been pretty much dead in the water for the last 6 or 7 minutes.
Well, the Huskies have turned up that man-to-man pressure defense, and they've really not allowed anything inside. And as Jay John's saying, you know, God, we had a big lead. We couldn't hold it. We probably got a little bit too conservative. A guy hits a big three that, you know, those either you got to be a little bit lucky or unlucky in that situation. But Nate Robinson made things happen. Now we got to come off. We got to play well now. We got to get going.
Washington starting the overtime like they started the game. They made 4 in a row to start the game, 3 in a row here in overtime. Lucas in traffic and a foul. That's sort of dancing what brung you. Go down to the low post and try to score or create a foul and get yourself to the free throw line.
Now here's that pass by Sakarakis and a good job to get it on the outside hand. And you see Rollins playing behind him inside, and a good job by Lucas just to draw the foul. And you see what he has done today. So obviously, the Beavers need something good right here. They need a couple of free throws to go down. They have to start picking up full court. They got to get active defensively.
1 out of 2 for Lucas. 5-point ball game.
The Huskies running their half-court sets, and I'm sure Lorenzo Romar will say this after the game, much better than they have in previous games. They're getting good motion and good penetration and good opportunity shots. High percentage off of their half-court motion. Again, look at that high to low.
Very good. Back door to Rollins, but he was too far under, and wisely backs it out. 6 on the shot clock now. Conroy to Roy. Got a good look, and he got it.
Again, Conroy. Drawn to defense. Look at that Husky bench. Now here's a club that is so hungry for a win.
That time Nash taking it hard at Rollins. Rollins got a little piece of the ball, but couldn't control the body. Got a piece of Nash as well.
Look at Will Conroy just set up Brandon Roy, and what he did was he tried to use his dribble to get a couple of guys around him and all the way think and pass. And look at Nate Robinson, who's on the bench right now, who was the catalyst for this team that brought him back. So you know, love to see that from a guy who's out of the game, now back in. But when you're sitting on that bench, be supportive.
So Robinson back out on the floor now. Nash will have another.
Yeah, the fans here, there's still a long way to go in this game. I mean, this is only a 5-point deficit. Obviously, then the Beavers need some stops, and they got to turn it up at this end of the floor.
But you're right. It's almost as though Washington got a wake-up call. They have just played so much more crisply than we've seen them play in the last 2 games they've played. And
don't forget, David Lucas, 4 fouls. So Rollins got to be alert for that, number 4. See, take it right at Lucas.
They did, and Lucas got a piece of the ball, knocked it out of bounds, 10 on the shot clock. Once again, a reminder that UCLA and Arizona women's basketball and then into the Big 12, Baylor and Texas Tech. Is that a... Here's Roy. Got close and followed his own shot in. He missed. It didn't block him out. He followed it home.
Well, all you saw was gold jerseys around that rim.
Now the clock's starting to be very much the ally of the Huskies. Nash off the window. 1:15 remaining in overtime.
Yeah, the problem is that the Beavers cannot stop the Huskies, and they haven't stopped them in the last 7-8 minutes. Look at Nate Robinson. He's a tough guy to steal it from.
Yeah, he is. Rob. Looked like Hurd going for the foul that time.
Oregon State foul, Lamar Hurd.
With 1:08 left, that'll put Robinson at the free throw line. Robinson at the line, 84% free throw shooter. Calmly knocks that down. Robinson with 22 today.
Pretty good second half by Nate Robinson.
Awesome.
He's got 21. in the second half. He's taking a page out of David Lucas's book, who got 22 in the second half against Oregon.
Well, now Oregon State in that position, they can't afford the empty possessions.
No, they need something. Not only, they got to look maybe three right now.
I mean, they do.
Yeah, you're down seven. You got to look for something on the outside.
Well, they're dropping down to Lucas. 51 ticks left.
You got a foul.
Got a foul. Yeah, we got a foul right now. Finally, they do. They put Conroy at the line. That was the 10th assist of the game for Hurd, incidentally. It equals his career high once again. Women's hoops coming your way. First in the pick in the Pac-10. UCLA and Arizona, then the Big 12, Baylor, and Texas Tech. And Jay John got to be thinking to himself, I had a 16-point lead in the second half. Conroy at the line.
Now, Conroy, 65% free throw shooter. Percentage-wise, if you're an Oregon State fan, this is the guy you want to the foul line. But he calmly knocks in the first one. The Beavers need a little bit of help. Obviously, if Washington's going to make all the free throws, the game's over. Oh, now you're sitting on a 7-point lead. Been a tremendous comeback for the Huskies.
They let Nash go. He makes the shot. Now you got a foul again.
30-second timeout.
Yeah, 30-second timeout called. And both coaches will talk strategy here, but right now this clock and certainly the scoreboard is the ally of the Washington Huskies.
Yeah, the strategy for the Huskies right here is to work on a solid out-of-bounds play just to get it in, because they know once they get it in, the Beavers cannot take too much time. They might look quick steal for a few 4 or 5 seconds, and then you got to look foul immediately. So if you're the Huskies, let's put in the great free throws. You said Allen was what, second in the all-time?
All-time.
In a Pac-10 in free throw shooting, so he'd be a guy you want in the game. Don't forget, coming up next, Barry, UCLA and Arizona, Texas Tech, Baylor women's basketball. And it'd be hard to get this into a second overtime, but not impossible.
Not impossible.
Not impossible.
Well, as you said, they've played 6 overtime periods, 3 overtime games, went to triple overtime with Kansas State.
Yeah, Oregon State, what, one and two. 1-2 in overtimes.
It was the triple overtime that they won.
All right, now the mindset for Lorenzo Romar and the Huskies is, when we run this out of bounds plays, let's try to get the ball in the hands of somebody like a Curtis Allen, who is not going to miss a free throw. I mean, even though it's a double bonus, you've got to get greedy if you're the Huskies. You don't want to miss any opportunity or make a turnover. You cannot turn the ball over here if you're Washington.
And there is the foul, and no time ran off the clock. So Conroy will go back to the free throw line.
His third personal.
Huskies have scored 14 points in this overtime period.
Started right away. I mean, the overtime, immediately they came out, scored 3 quick field goals, put some distance between they and Oregon State, and the Beavers just have not been able to come back. Now Conroy gives a glimmer, and it's a small one, but a glimmer of hope here to Oregon State. Now, I think they got to be thinking 3, Barry. I think you got to put Sakarakis back in the game. You've got to think someone has to go down and make a 3 for Oregon State. You know, here's the other big thing. You look at the Oregon State lineup, they don't have any big guys on the floor. I mean, now that Washington doesn't have anybody on the line, you don't worry about a miss.
1 out of 2. And they have no time to waste here. Now Nash.
Got to be thinking 3.
Can't dance around, though. You got to do something. Nash finally pops the 3. It won't go.
Look
Nash
at Nate.
Just about do it.
Yeah, Nate Robinson. And he's showing you can rebound. Is he a leaper?
No.
Oh, can he get up?
Well, a great athlete. He's got a great body.
Chris Stevens, the foul. And fourth.
Well, this win will go down for the Huskies. One of those impressive come-from-behind learning experiences for Oregon State. But never say die Washington comes back and looks like they're going to get this one.
Yeah. I mean, that says a lot about the character of that Husky
team.
Sure
does. Yes, it does. You know, you think you're 0-5 coming in the conference. I mean, you don't get this one. You're thinking to yourself, we go down 0-6, and we still got Arizona's to play.
They got to go over and play Washington State this week.
And then that's
not easy.
Not easy at all.
Nate Robinson calmly knocks them both in. 100 points. The last time, incidentally, Oregon State gave up 100 points was back in 1995 to Oregon. Sakarakis missed everything. Stevens underneath, he misses and follows it in.
That was a pass by Sakarakis.
Yeah, I think it was.
He's trying to find that guy under the goal.
Now 20 seconds left in a 6-point game.
Favorite foul, Angelo Sakarakis.
Well, you sure thought, and Jay John, I mean, this is a tough loss for Oregon State. This is one that kind of a hard time for this, for everybody from Oregon State to go to bed tonight and not wake up and think about this game. It's a tough one.
Yeah, it is.
Just got to bounce back. You know, you talk about the youth of the Beavers and maybe a little bit more experience. You don't lose this game in future years, but Washington just found a way to come back and make big shots.
Nash going all the way to the basket.
Yes,
15 seconds left and a 5-point ball game.
Still got to inbound the ball.
They get it in and now the foul. And this crowd got very quiet very quickly and the Oregon bench, of course, obviously Stevens is fouled out of the game.
Tremendous.
Not too many smiles on the Oregon State bench. He had 23 points in the game.
He played a wonderful game, and this young man here will be a terrific player and is a terrific player at Oregon State. He should have quite a career here.
Vic Remmers will come on to replace him.
I think right now Jay John is talking to the officials because you remember at the end of regulation there were a couple of calls he was not 100% happy with, and of course he's got a minute to sub. And no matter what the official says here, I think Jay was going to take that full minute before he got a guy in the game. It's not totally impossible here, Barry.
It's not. I've seen it happen before.
Like you're too busy.
All right, now you got to go quick through, or you can't waste any time. Shoot it.
Well, wasting too much, I think. Couldn't get it to go, and that should finally
do it. And the other thing that the Huskies did, I thought, did a great job of keeping the ball out of Sakarakis' hands, not only late in regulation, but in the overtime. I mean, he's the go-to guy to make a three, but couldn't get open. A little different when you're playing against the zone and when you're playing against the man-to-man.
Yeah, it is.
Andy Hook checking in for the Beavers. Will Conroy at the line for the Huskies.
So now with 5.1 ticks remaining, the crowd here at Gill Coliseum starts to exit. Conroy goes back to the line. Jay John will replay this one in his mind a lot.
Yeah, and conversely, if you're Lorenzo Romar, this may be a real turning point game in your year. I mean, you got off to a tough start, and you're looking to make a comeback, and this is one that will allow you to come back. It's a bomb there right at the end.
Yeah, he did, to make it a 4-point game as it ends. So I want to remind you that most of you will be watching the women's game between UCLA and Arizona or Baylor at Texas Tech. That's coming up in just a minute. Final score here, 103-99 in overtime. The Huskies beat the Beavers. That's a wrap for us. For Dan Bellomini, I'm Barry Tompkins. So long, everybody.